Candidate name, Henry Birkinshaw. Candidate session number 4388003. For the purpose of this presentation, I'll be performing a text analysis on the extract from The Wind That Shakes the Barley. My 5-minute clip begins approximately 1 hour 50 minutes into the film with a mid-shot of Damien in his prison cell, talking to his brother Teddy, and ends at approximately 1 hour 55 minutes with a shot of Teddy just after he gave the command to his soldiers to execute his brother Damien. I've chosen this extract because it shows how war affects even the closest relationships, and I also believe that it made a very interesting climax to the film due to its unpredictability. The Wind That Shakes the Barley includes lots of themes such as violence, war, death and anger, as well as love between the two brother protagonists, Damien and Teddy. Loach was very well known for his socialist attitude, and this is highlighted within the film as he shows a sympathetic view on the Republicans in the Irish Civil War and the Irish War of Independence. Loach was also very well known for his realist approach of films. He tried to incorporate characters so they had genuine interplay. As well as this, Loach makes sure that the film is shot chronologically, as he believes this helps actors find an instant response to their actions during the film. This is reflected well in my film, because as a viewer you really understand their emotions and thoughts in every scene. A very similar film to the one I'm analysing is called Land and Freedom, released in 1995, again directed by Ken Loach. This film explores similar themes to The Wind That Shakes the Barley, such as war, death and violence. The key opposition used by Ken Loach is the contrast in attitudes between the British and Irish. This is clear very early on in the narrative when the British Black and Tan storm the house where the two brothers live, resulting in Damien's friend's execution. This initial action provokes sympathy for the Irish Republican army. This also suggests a binary opposition of strong versus weak. This stereotypical opposition is used to make the audience feel sorry for the weak side, therefore disliking the strong. And this could change through the course of the narrative, though, as the weak side fight back. One aspect that is interesting is that Loach is a British director, so why would he want to provoke more sympathy towards the IRA? This view suggests that he believes everyone should have an open view on the film and cast their own opinions of it. With this idea in mind, a typical binary opposition of good versus evil is eradicated because of the mutual perspective of the director. Todorov's narrative theory is also put in place in my film, as the film starts conventionally with a state of equilibrium where a group of men are hurling. This is then interrupted majorly during the course of the narrative as the wars take place. Equilibrium is then returned after Damien's death, as it symbolises the downfall of the IRA. Another film by Ken Loach, very similar to that of The Wind That Shakes the Barley, is The Spirit of 45. A film directed by Ken Loach, which describes the unity of the soldiers in the Second World War and how they managed to overcome all obstacles to create a freer and better and fairer society. This film relates highly to The Wind That Shakes the Barley, and I'm sure The Wind That Shakes the Barley was an influence for this film, as it is going to be released in 2013. From an audience's perspective, one is led to believe that the film would target young adults up to an old age, in The Wind That Shakes the Barley, as war is not a theme that one would introduce to children. The fact that many deaths occur during the film makes it emotionally engaging, as well as the development of characters, especially Damien, as he is altered as a person due to the war taking place. The film took place during the Irish War of Independence and the Civil War, which took place during the early 20th century. It's a very typical war film showing many deaths and violence, and as discussed earlier, Loach sympathises for the Irish. However, he still shows, in my opinion, a mutual perspective on the matter, which defies typical conventions of a war film. A message about how war can alter aspects of a human's nature is shown through Damien and sent as a response about how disastrous this can be. This does not make the audience dislike Damien, but feel more attached to the protagonist, as he shouldn't be in the war. The genre of my film is a war drama, and this genre acknowledges horror and heartbreak of war, which allows the fighting to configure the primary plot of the film. Social realism is a movement which refers to filmmakers drawing thought towards their everyday lives of the working class and are critical of the social structures that maintain these states of affairs. Nowadays, social realism is closely acquainted with art house auteur. Now, Loach used this movement by showing the characters living in quite a low-class environment, out with very little luxuries and costumes which don't really represent that of a middle or higher class status. The film was produced in the Studio 16 Films and Matador Pictures, and of course Ken Loach is a very established British director with financial backing. The film was a very good economic success as it became the most popular independent Irish film ever released, earning €377,000 in its first weekend of release, and €2.7 million by August 2006. In total, the box office amount was just under $23 million, so a very economically successful film throughout the world. Moving on to my text and analysis, I'll be talking about editing, sound, mise-en-scène and the camera, and I chose this certain 5-minute clip out because I believe it contributed significantly to the narrative, providing a displacement of equilibrium after Damien's death, and also a strained relationship between Damien and his brother. The 5-minute clip that I'm analysing explores the relationship and tests their love for each other when Teddy sentences him to death. I also believe that war changes a person mentally, and this is expressed through Damien's resilience to defy the IRA, therefore ending up defying his brother, who he loved more than anyone in the film. This part of the film signifies the downfall of the IRA due to Damien's death, and also other reasons I think it is important are expressed below. The first few shots of my 5-minute clip consist of shot reverse shots of the two protagonists from a medium to close shot length as Teddy is in conversation with Damien. The camera alternates between these medium and close shots to get different to see the different facial expressions of the characters, and it also makes the audience feel involved and part of the conversation. They have a mutual view on the matter, seeing the views from both sides of the table, and Loach has done this to show that neither side were right or wrong in their actions, and he shares a mutual view like them. Although Teddy is the more powerful of the two, as he is now part of the Irish Free State Army and the captain of the Irish Free State Army, the director has shown him as the inferior of the two because he knows consequently that Damien will not betray the IRA. And also, more camera time is placed on Teddy, as Loach knows that the audience will be more interested in his facial expressions and body language due to his brother defying him. His negative body language foreshadows what is to come when Damien is on his own in the cell, and the camera is at a distant proximity from the protagonist, not allowing the audience to see his face and his emotions. This is put into place to show the separation he feels from the rest of the world due to his soon-to-be execution. During the execution scene, there are a series of fast cuts from a medium to long shot distance to show the tenseness of the situation and the plethora of the emotions occurring. This is then followed by two quite long cuts, one showing the dead Damien and the other showing his very emotional brother. These are quickly contrasted to show the facial expressions of both and how the emotions are being shared, because his brother is obviously very upset that Damien has just died. And finally, the proximity of the characters is far closer than what it is in the cell, and the director's intention here is to show the audience it is a far more important scene and it provokes emotions in the viewers. And finally, overall, the simple continuity of the editing allows the audience to easily understand the narrative. The dialogue between Teddy and Damien is spoken at a very slow pace and almost spoken under their breaths. They both know that if Damien does not comply with the amnesty made by Teddy, that he will die, hence the very quiet tones of voice used. When Teddy tells Damien that he will be shot at dawn, the viewer knows that he doesn't want it to happen due to his emotion in his voice. Following on from this, Damien is left on his own and writing his final letters to his loved ones. His voice has become the voiceover as he reads out his love letter. This is non-diegetic sound, and the director's intention here is to show the audience that this is the first time Damien's personal and private thoughts were expressed. Before, he spoke for the whole of the IRA, but now, due to the fact he is on his own, he is expressing his own thoughts and views, which makes it another very emotional part of the film, and foreshadows a saddening end to come. During his voiceover, strings are used to intensify the scene, provoke sadness, to make it far more tense leading up to his death. The very slow pace of the cello being played emphasises his emotions, but as well as this, it relates to when Damien is saying, to what Damien is saying, as he says about how the war may last longer than they originally realised and how it is dragging on without finding conclusion. All non-diegetic music then stops as he kisses his charm and then cuts to him marching out to his death. The fact there is no sound makes the situation far tenser and in a way shows the audience that the climax is near. And the next time we hear instruments is just after the death, just after he rejects wearing a piece of white cotton placed over his heart by his brother Teddy. This is obviously a pivotal moment, and hence why piano is being played as well as the strings. Once again, the music is very slow-paced and slowly increases in pace as Teddy shouts commands to his comrades. Once again, building up to a climax. When fire is shouted, all music stops for a second, and the director's intentions here is to show respect to the fallen and for the audience to have a brief second to reflect on all that have been lost. Once he has been shot, one continuous note is played, therefore being very plain but emotional. This dies out and is taken over by the diegetic sound of Teddy grovelling over his fallen brother. The most dominant visuals throughout my 5-minute clip are the two protagonists of the film. The contrasting facial expressions and emotions between the two brothers are interesting to the viewer, as you see Damien's doggedness to not give in and Teddy's anxiousness not to send him to his death. Throughout the jail cell scene, it is easy to see from the viewer's perspective that Damien is putting on a very brave face in order to not show any weakness to his brother. This steadfast mindset is blown out the window when he is strapped to the pole, finally showing the audience his true emotions. Moving back to the jail cell scene, the lighting is very dark, and the director's intention here is to create an eerie and almost undercover atmosphere. This is done because Loach wants it to be seen that Teddy wants to help his brother despite being oppositions. They're almost speaking under their breaths against the sides that they are fighting for due to the brotherly love that they share. The only light seen in the scene is from the small candle on the table giving off a low-key light, which creates shadow on both characters' faces. This shows that each character may be hiding some thoughts and emotions that they want to keep concealed in front of each other in order to not show weakness. A very low-intensity fill light is also used, and the director's intention here is to try and add a softer edge to the scene. The darkness is then contrasted with a bright natural light at the place of execution. The two protagonists are mainly always together in my clip, therefore they are framed either side of centre. This shows the separation between the two since they became oppositions, and also shows how they could never act like brothers again. The shot where they are closest is when Teddy is placing white fabric on his brother, which the director has added in because it shows that although they are on different sides of the Civil War, the love and respect between each other for them is still there. The close-ups and medium shots used during the conversation between the two brothers in the prison cell shows each character's facial expressions, and from a viewer's perspective it provides them with knowledge on how they are feeling and the emotions they have. Far more close-ups and medium shots are used on Damien than they are on Teddy, and this is because the director wants the audience to know that he is the more important of the two characters at this point in time because of what is going to happen to him. As well as this, there is one shot which I think is very good, as it is of Damien sitting on the table in on his own whilst his brother is standing over him. This is a long shot distance, and you are able to see the whole of each character. This shot can have many representations, and one of the most important representations is his segregation from everyone else around him. He is alone and shows that he is fighting this war alone with no one by his side. An alternative reading is that he doesn't belong in this environment. He shouldn't be back. He should be back with his wife Sinead and being a teacher instead of being a soldier fighting in a war, which should never have been. All that is represented in this shot, and that is why it is so important. The tracking medium shot of Teddy walking past his comrade without speaking is also very interesting, as it shows how he has the power and authority over his soldiers and how he is the most dominant of characters. The effect of the movement of the shot creates an idea that the camera is stuck with him, tracking his every move. Therefore, the audience are tracking his every move and watching over him. The side profile close-up used when Damien is writing his letter doesn't show much of his face at all, concealing his thoughts from the audience but expressing them through voiceover. The handheld medium shot of when Damien rejects the white material makes the scene very personal, almost like the audience are there themselves. Wind That Shakes the Barley received many awards, including the Palme d'Or at the Cannes Festival, which means the best feature film. And this is one of the top awards, so obviously quite a few critics approved of its messages and the overall way in which the film's created. It also won the best film in the Irish Film and Television Awards, with a few others. These awards prove it was very successful all the way around the world. A review written from Peter Bradshaw from The Guardian states, "It is not Lucha's best film, but it is a fine and powerful drama with relevant things to say about what happens when an occupying force withdraws it from an It is a film about anger and bitterness, but there are, as it happens, characteristic moments of gentle, unworldly Lochian humour, as when a boy on a bicycle brings news of the British ceasefire to the Republicans and loses that bit of paper with the vital facts." The fact humour was used, I find very interesting, because it adds a different perspective to the film and also a different dynamic. Although not in my 5-minute clip, it shows that Loach is willing to showcase the war that took place to people of today and suggest it shouldn't be a film which makes people sad, but a film that should be people should be proud of. Loach has successfully managed to educate the audience of today about the two wars that took place in the early 20th century, and in my personal opinion, it is a film that expresses not only the wrongdoings that were done during this tragic time, but the monumentous courage shown by the soldiers to fight for their country.